Marjorie Taylor Greene says the problem is that white men do not have enough support, advocacy, and representation at the United States Capitol. Also, Donald Trump has now threatened to run against the GOP. Fascinating. Let me take you to the Marjorie Taylor Greene footage. Here it is.
But the problem is, Glenn, there's not a lot of lobbyists here for regular Mr. and Mrs. American. You know, like mom and pop shops, the single mom trying to make it, the guy, the average white male trying to climb the corporate ladder when his problem is being white and male. So there's not people in here fighting for regular Americans. You just have lobbyists fighting for big corporations and industries.
Whoa, wait a minute, Marjorie Taylor Greene. I thought you were against critical race theory. What you have just described is actually critical race theory. Yeah, obviously reversed, but the concept. I mean, you're saying that a white man cannot really get a fair shake in the United States of America. It is interesting to note that if you go back and look at that footage again, you will see that Marjorie Taylor Greene says, you know, I'm talking about regular Americans. Mr. and Mrs. America. I'm talking about mom and pop. So I'm talking about white people. Okay? Remember, she went from Americans to then telling you what her definition of America actually means. White men. Well, it's interesting because Marjorie Taylor Greene is actually historically accurate. Only white men who own property could actually participate in democracy upon the founding of this nation. So when they say, we want to make America great again, I think Marjorie Taylor Greene, for the first time, has alluded to the error they are talking about. All right, so 88.8% of CEOs in America, CFOs, COOs included in 2022 were white. 88.1% were men. Thanks for fighting for the underdog, Marge, tweeted Michigan State Board of Education member Mitchell Robinson. Marge should be assured that we will all keep it secret that white males are still big time in corporate USA, replied former Australia MP Laurie Ferguson. Last year, she attended the America First Political Action Conference, remember that? A white nationalist gathering organized by neo-Nazis and self-described Hitler supporter Nick Fuentes. She later backtracked and disavowed Fuentes and his ideology. She has also frequently claimed that white men are a persecuted identity. Isn't that interesting? Once again, she believes in critically thinking about race only when it applies to the race of white men. She's not even an advocate for white women. White women should be offended by this. There's more. Let me go to former President Donald Trump. All right, so former President Trump, well, he just laid something on him, has made it clear he is willing to throw the GOP under the bus in 2024 if they do not choose him as their nominee. Effectively, a threat to hand the election to Democrats and burn it all down for Republicans. You know, Mitch McConnell actually said this a while ago. He said Donald Trump is going to burn the house down if he could. Well, here's the thing, McConnell. You're the one who gave him the keys to the home. You put his name on the lease and you let him buy it for $1. You sold your party cheap to a con man. And now that the con man has residential rights inside of your home known as the Republican Party, all of a sudden there's a problem. But you knew exactly who he was upon handing him the key and signing over the lease. You knew there was no ambiguity about the character, personality of Donald Trump. He was never a transformational candidate nor politician. He was always transactional. You like that about them because you thought it could deliver wins for you, increase your power, get corporations on your side. You now are faced with the reality of what you have done, McConnell and others. A defeated Trump could upend the GOP's 2024 nominee simply by forcing the candidate to choose between publicly dissing him and alienating MAGA voters, or sucking up to him in a way that would undermine any talk of a fresh start for the party. Anyone who thinks Trump would not put his own pride ahead of the good of the Republican Party hasn't been paying attention. And I agree with Kilgore on that sentiment. This is the reality of Donald Trump. I think it's quite amazing that anyone in the Republican Party would be surprised by this. I think it's quite laughable that we should somehow act outraged by the actions of Donald Trump. No, I'm happy. I hope he splits the party, all right? Because honestly, probably the only way the Democrats are going to win in a presidential election cycle. So good for him. The Democrats are on it. Hopefully the DNC will partially fund Trump's independent campaign for president. All right. Jordan, thoughts, brother?
So Marjorie Taylor Greene's comments about how white men don't get a fair shake in our economy and Trump's overall strategy, both of these together represent the dangers of right-wing populism. They pay lip service to this issue where corporations have outsized influence in our politics. She even names it. She talks about the proliferation of corporate lobbyists in Congress. But what they're doing is they're appealing and pandering to real economic anxiety that everybody feels, and only speaking to the white experience in that class struggle. And for those people who are on the receiving end that they can relate to that, like white men, working class white men, sure, that's what they want to hear. But what we need to do is talk about how these class issues affect everybody and create a more equitable, multicultural society. That is how we create a more fair, equitable, and judicial system. Like that's the utopia, right? But what she's doing is so dangerous because it pits the enemy as people of color, as marginalized communities. That's not the enemy. The enemy is the capitalist class who are trying to keep your wages low, who are laying off people and replacing them with things like ChatGPT. That's the danger. People who are union busting, that's the danger. It is not someone who doesn't look like you also vying for the same job. It is the boss, it is the capitalist class, and it is the wealthy.
Well said, so well said. Your enemy is never the person, it is the policy. They create a framework and then pit you against each other. They create a budget and say no more money is available, so you have to fight for these pennies we're going to give you, and we fall for it. It is all an illusion. They are picking the plays. All right, we shall see exactly what Trump does in the future. We'll bring it to you as it develops.